Hello and welcome to yet another thread of medicinal chemistry. This is Dr. V. H. Atpalliwar taking you through in a class of medicinal chemistry to introduce neurotransmitters. We have introduced neurotransmitters in the last thread as the chemicals released by the nerve endings. These chemicals, they control several actions in the body. The first and foremost chemical to be established as a neurotransmitter was acetylcholine. It is conveniently nicknamed or abbreviated as ACH. It is this name, acetylcholine, which gives names parasympathetic nervous system as cholinergic system. So, acetylcholine is a neurotransmitter in the parasympathetic nervous system. It has got several pharmacological implications. The first and foremost important is the involuntary muscle contractions. That is, we call as reflex action. For example, movement of eyelids to save the inner parts of the eye from air or any foreign material. Lacrimal secretion, tears rolling down the eye. Flushing of the face whenever a person gets happy, his feeling cannot be hidden because reddening of the face. That's involuntary. Vagal stimulation. It invariably brings watery secretion in the buccal chamber. Whenever a person feels hungry or thinks of a food or any sweet, its buccal chamber fills with watery secretion of saliva. That is under in the control of ACH. It has got severe role in controlling the heart contractions. The effect of acetylcholine over the heart muscle, that is myocardial muscle, is negative inotropic effect as well as negative chronotropic effect. Both combined, it reduces the cardiac output. It stimulates the hormones and controls sexuality. It maintains the gut motility in GIT and regulates digestive system. Now diverting our attention towards the structure of acetylcholine. This is an important part in the chemistry, in understanding medicinal chemistry. Now if you look the structure of acetylcholine very carefully, it is a very simple structure. One wonders how a simple and small structure controls such important actions of the body. It is an ester of acetic acid and choline. This choline is an amino alcohol which is prepared from ethanol amine. The nitrogen in the ethanol amine, that is in acetylcholine, is quaternized due to presence of this 3-methyl group. This is an important aspect in its structure-activity relationship. The distance between this nitrogen and the terminal hydrogen here is of 5 atoms, that is first carbon, second carbon, third oxygen, fourth carbon and fifth carbon. This observation was proposed by Ng, hence it is famous as Ng's rule. Now you may pause for a while, think it over and write in your journal whatever you have just seen about acetylcholine. You may indeed have written some information about acetylcholine. We may now move over to next neurotransmitter. The next neurotransmitter in line is norepinephrine. It is popularly called as noradrenaline. This neurotransmitter is released by sympathetic nervous system. The nerve endings of sympathetic nervous system, or popularly called as adrenergic nervous system, releases norepinephrine as its neurotransmitter. This neurotransmitter norepinephrine prepares the body to combat or face challenging situations or stress conditions. These conditions are called as fright and flight response. It has got a positive chronotropic and positive inotropic effect on the myocardial muscle, which increases the cardiac output. It helps in directing the blood and increasing the blood flow to the regions of the body which requires it. It also induces glycogenolysis, which provides glucose to the parts of the body requiring at the time of fright and flight. It relaxes the bronchial smooth muscle and dilates the respiratory tract. This effect helps in filling the lungs with more air, thereby increasing the percentage of oxygen available for the blood. More oxygen and more glucose supplied to the skeletal muscles, the part of body which is required during fright and flight, to provide energy. It also induces peripheral vasoconstriction, thereby restricting the flow of blood in the periphery and directing the blood towards the central blood vessels. Hence, norepinephrine prepares the body in challenging situations to face it. Now, coming to the chemistry part of norepinephrine. As you can see here, it contains one aromatic ring which has got substitutions on adjacent carbons. It has got another substitution of a chain that is an alkyl chain which has also an amino group. Collectively, this whole structure can be called a derivative of catechol because of this catechol, a 1,2-dihydroxybenzene, or it may also be called as aryl ethanol amine. Aryl ethanol amine because of this alcoholic hydroxy group which is present on the beta position. The amino group in norepinephrine is essentially is primary. Now you may pause for a while, think it over and write about the chemistry part of norepinephrine and the pharmacological implications of the neurotransmitter in your journal. You may definitely have written something about norepinephrine. There are other neurotransmitters, many in number, which are serotonin, dopamine, gamma-aminobutyric acid known as the inhibitory neurotransmitter, NMDA, and many more. These are to name a few neurotransmitters. Thank you.